Help you?
Yeah. A friend of mine recommended this place. He said you had a lot of unusual books.
That's right. What's your interest?
Horror. But the really good stuff.
Bone chilling.
Right.
What are you tasting for? Stephen King? Robert Bloch?
Maybe. What else?
Of course there's H.P. Lovecraft, but you can't go wrong with Gary Bradner.
You know, that all sounds really good, but I've already read most of that. I was thinking more obscure.
Okay, horror sections right up and down that entire aisle. I'm sure there's something down there that's scary.
I really didn't think he was gonna stay this long.
You act like you don't want him here.
He's always following me around. He needs to get his own set of friends.
He's still adjusting to losing your parents. And so are you. It's obvious he looks up to you.
Yeah, I know. It's just, it gets old after a while, you know?
Way too much to drink.
This sucks.
No, not to worry. I meant that it's just...
You're making a lot of sense, Vince.
Don't worry about her. She turns everyone down the first time.
Look, I'm having a great time tonight. It's just, I think I've had too much to drink.
Yeah, we were noticing that.
So what do you say, Robert? You give me a ride home?
Perfect. You drink too much and make an ass of yourself, and I have to clean up the mess. You see, this is what I'm talking about.
What the hell, Robert?
Hey, your brother's asking you a favor, and a smart one at that. Just go, drop him off, and come right back.
No way, I'm not gonna do that. Here, if you need protection on the way home, this will protect you.
Alright.
You know, that's the shittiest thing I've ever seen you do.
Yeah, I hear another beer calling my name.
I'm the last person you want to hear from today, huh?
Everything still sucks. Especially this piece of shit holiday.
Anyway, like I promised you, I'm here. On this day. This is really hard, man. I know you have every reason to hold it against me forever, but I'm sorry. I'd trade places with you if I could. I miss Mom and Dad.
What the hell are you doing there? What are you doing here, I asked?
Chill out, old man. I'm just visiting my brother's grave.
That better be what you're doing. Every year, Halloween, kids your age come here to drink, fuck, and who knows what the hell else. They leave the entire place a mess, and I'm cleaning and picking up shit for days.
That's not what I'm doing, so back off.
Tell all your friends if any bullshit goes down here tonight, they'll be tasting my shovel.
Did you invite that Robert guy to the party tonight?
Yeah, I did. What's your problem with him?
Nothing really. He's just kind of weird.
He seems nice enough. He's just always depressed, you know?
Were you guys at one time?
No, we were really good friends around 3 years ago. His brother Vince died in a crash after my Halloween party. And Robert feels responsible.
From what I heard, he is.
Regardless, he could use some friends. Because of what happened, he hates Halloween and wants nothing to do with it.
If he hates Halloween, why are you inviting him to a Halloween party?
Because it's time he got over it. I invited him the last 2 years.
I don't remember him being there.
Well, he wasn't. He just stayed at home and had his house bombed by eggs and toilet paper.
I think it's a long shot.
I got him to agree to meet me at the costume shop. I think I can talk him into it.
Well, isn't that him pulling up now?
Yeah, that's him.
Well, we've got to get going, but good luck.
We'll see you at the party tonight.
Bye. Okay, bye.
Hey, Robert. Thanks for coming.
Yeah. I don't know what I'm doing here.
Because you promised me you would look at costumes and consider coming to my party tonight.
Linda, I really don't want to do this.
I think it would be good for you.
It's only been 3 years.
That's long enough. It's time you start living again.
It's not even the party. It's fucking Halloween. All this holiday does is serve as a reminder.
I didn't say it would be easy. But if you come to the party tonight, more good would come out of it than bad.
If it was a 4th of July party, I would totally come, but not Halloween.
Well, what are you going to do then?
Same as last two Halloweens. Watch the Horrorthon Movie Fest on TV.
Okay. I came prepared in case I failed. Take this. At least hand out candy to the trick-or-treaters so they don't soap your windows and TV your house again.
Thanks for trying. Maybe next year.
Well, if you change your mind, you know where I live.
Thank you. Forget it. He never hands out any candy.
And coming up next on WWAR, Horrorthon with Guy Marks, a Halloween night edition, starts now.
Good evening, boys and girls. This is your favorite horror host, Guy Marks. Special Halloween edition of Horrorthon. Horrific lineup to frighten you again this year. Last year, I terrified you with the mysterious Planet Debbie. This year, we start with the zombie classic, Night of the Living Dead.
Well, hurry up, Richie, so I can light this thing.
You got the eggs?
Yeah.
Well, give me one of them. Shit! Run!
Trick or treat, mister.
Now leave me alone.
Thank you.
Hey, Linda. It's Robert. Tell whatever asshole from your party that was just down here trying to spook me to... Oh. You don't know what I'm talking about. Somebody was just flashing a jack-o'-lantern in my window that looked just like the one I gave Vince that night. And I could swear I just saw Vince's car drive by him. Hello? Linda! Hello? Who said that? Who's here?
Thank you.
So the company sent me out here to get the local office in order. And after everything I'd been through, I thought maybe moving to Wildwood would be just the thing for me.
Yeah, like a change of pace.
Exactly. A new place, You know, start over, make some new friends. Hell, I thought if things worked out well, I'd just go ahead and put in for a permanent transfer.
So what happened?
Nothing worked. I was cordial and outgoing and friendly. Couldn't make a single freaking friend in this town. Sarpede, except for you. You've been great.
Oh, that's all right.
But all you other people are unfriendly.
Welcome to Wildwood. Everybody here is like that. And what are you going to do, right?
Yeah, I'm just glad it's my last night in this crummy little town. All right, I'm going to the hotel.
Come on, have another drink.
Listen, Pete, you've been great. You're the only one I've enjoyed talking to for the last month. You've been a good friend.
I'm always here. If you want to come back.
Well, I gotta keep a clear head so I can drive out of here.
All right.
W. Who the hell's W? Well, beats the crap out of watching TV on.
Great. Practical joke. Perfect way to leave this shit town.
Must be Len Krager.
Yeah, I'm Len, but I don't think that I...
Come in. We've been waiting for you.
You have?
Well, we didn't exactly hold up the party. But we've been anxious to meet you. First thing we need to do is get you a drink. Follow me to the bar. Just another guest. Call me Harry.
I was afraid I was going to be a little early. But, seems like this party's been going on for quite some time.
Seems like forever. Come on, join the gang.
I should say hello to the host, whoever he is or she is. There's plenty of time for that, Lance. Plenty of time. So, Harry, what do you do?
Do?
Yeah, what kind of business are you?
I do a little this, a little of that. Excuse me for a second, will you, Len?
Got a match?
I quit a few years ago.
I should quit too, I suppose.
I'm Lynn Krager, and I'm staying at the...
Yes, I know. Call me Carol.
Carol, can I ask you something?
Of course.
How do you know me? Everybody here seems to recognize me, and I can't figure it out. Because I've seen a lot of people since I've been in town, but I don't recognize any of them.
People look different at a party.
You live around here?
Have you had anything to eat?
Actually, I'm not that hungry. I ate at the hotel earlier. I didn't want to get here too early.
Oh, you can't come here too early. And you should try the food. It is marvelous.
Maybe I will have a bite. You join me?
I've already had mine. But you help yourself. It's good.
On the way to the food?
I guess I was.
Fine. We'll go together. I hate to eat alone. Don't you, Lynn?
Yeah, I suppose so.
What's wrong?
Do you know who that is at the window?
Who?
Never mind.
Good, let's go.
Do I know you?
Does anybody know anybody? Call me John. Nice bread, isn't it?
Tell me, John, who is the host here anyway?
Enjoy yourself, Len. I gotta see a man about a dollar.
Yo, Len! I saw you left this at the bar, so I topped it off for you.
Is that okay?
Yeah, thanks. Hey, listen. Harry, you see that woman who was out there?
Woman?
Yeah, outside. She was all dressed in black. She had these really piercing eyes. Saw her a couple times from the bar, and then just now here.
By God, I think he saw old Mary.
Old Mary?
Old Mary Grower. She used to live here a long time ago. Crazy as a coot. No, I mean really crazy. She killed people. Nobody knows how many. Bums, misfits, runaways. She said she felt sorry for them. She lured them here. And then... ka-chop!
Ka-chop?
An axe. Old Mary used an axe. They finally put her away in a nut house. Kept her there till the day she died.
Yeah, but... I'm still seeing...
You must have seen Old Mary's ghost. They say she still stalks around the grounds on certain moonless nights.
Yeah, but you don't believe that stuff, do you, Harry?
In the end, does it matter who believes what? In 100 years, it's not going to make a difference. Nice talking to you, Len.
Did Harry come in here?
I wasn't watching.
Carol, what's up with these people here?
Why? Is someone bothering you?
No, I'm not getting bothered. Everyone's been really friendly. Actually, they're too friendly. And they all speak in riddles, and nobody gives me a straight answer. I still haven't met the host. Everybody here seems to know me. I don't know any of them. I don't even know your last name.
Do those things really matter?
Well, the part about your last name matters to me. You know, Carol, I was supposed to leave town tomorrow, but I could stick around. I'd like to see you again.
You'll see me.
Really? Phone number? Last name? Anything?
You probably already knew that. Everybody else around here seems to.
I'm your hostess.
The Lady W.
I'm afraid you misread my script. The initials M for my first name. I'm Mary. Mary Grauer.
Hey, what's going on here?
They have something to show you.
Working on it, baby.
Working on it is not good enough.
Working on it. Gotta save my money so I can get something decent.
I guess. I gotta go.
Okay.
Love you.
Bye. Love you too.
Bye.
Thank you.
$700. That price can't be right.
Hello.
Hi. I was calling about the car you have for sale.
Yeah.
You haven't sold it yet, have you?
Oh, hell no. I just parked it out there a few hours ago. You're my first call.
Well, the sign says 700. Is that,
Yeah. Yeah, that's the price. Can you be at my house tomorrow, say, 2?
Yeah, I can definitely be there at 2.
I can discuss selling it to you in person.
What's your address?
709 Lampkin Lane. My name is Eddie.
709 Lampkin. Yeah, gotcha. Well, see you tomorrow at 2.
Yeah.
Thanks.
Talk to me, Jeff.
Bro, I have a massive favor to ask you.
You usually do.
Well, I need a ride tomorrow at 2. I'm seeing this guy about maybe buying his car.
Really? Your cheap ass is finally getting some wheels. I thought you weren't even close to having enough money.
Look, if things work out, I don't think money's actually going to be an issue.
Alright, I'll pick you up at 1:30.
Thanks, man. I owe you.
Kathy hasn't dumped your sorry ass yet. Taking her on light rails and buses? Bro, that shit is way overdue.
Dude, I know, man. I'm not a fan of taking the light rail downtown just to do homework, but it is what it is. It sucks.
Well, that's about to change. So are you sure it wasn't 7,000?
The sign said 700. He said 700, so 700 it is. Nah, hey, here's Lampkin Lane, so you're gonna want to turn right.
Damn, you robbing a guy. Are you sure you want me to wait here and make sure things go right?
Nah, man, I'm good. I got this. Think so.
All right, bro.
See you later.
Later.
Cool, buddy. Mr. Allen? I'm Jeff. I called yesterday about the car. $700 is a very fair price for your car, Mr. Allen.
It's Eddie. And it's not my car.
It isn't?
No, it's my brother's.
Should I be talking to him?
You can't.
Why not?
He's dead. This is him. car was left to me when he died.
And you don't want it?
Tommy loved that car. He said, if anything should ever happen to him, I shouldn't sell it. But...
I mean, I have cash. I mean, I could pay you right now.
Here's the title. It's notarized and signed. Just sign on the bottom.
You know, before I sign this, I just have to ask. Is there anything wrong with the car?
No. It works perfectly.
Not everything works perfectly, huh, Eddie?
Oh my god, I can't believe it. This is like totally great.
I told you.
So the guy you got it from is kind of creepy, huh?
Yeah, there's something odd about him.
He had a nice car.
Well, actually it was his brother's. And unfortunately, there's no back seat.
So?
Okay, wait. Real quick. I'm gonna take a picture first. Hey, you ready? Okay. So Facebook. Looks good.
I'm telling you, man, there is something strange happening with this car.
Jeff, what's with you? You finally get a car and you're acting crazy?
Like whatever you want, man, but either those brakes are fucked up or...
your car is possessed or something. I mean,
the car switched into reverse and nearly ran me down. I
don't know how something like that happens, you know?
Bro, tell you what. How about I come by tonight, take a look at the brakes? I even check out the engine as well.
And by the time I get done with it, you know if anything needs to be fixed.
Thanks, man. I owe you again.
Yeah. Starting to add up, man. Later.
Jeff, what are you doing?
I'm just waiting for Devin to get here. He's gonna check the brakes on the car, so...
Why, what's up?
Jeff.
Baby, what's wrong? You sound kind of freaked.
No, I'm looking at the picture from last night.
Is it that bad?
There's someone in the car.
Baby, are you drinking again? It was just me and you last night, remember?
No, I'm telling you, there's someone in the front seat, and I don't know who it is. Look, I'm coming over.
All right, babe. Drive safe, okay? You want me to stay out here and give you a hand, or?
Man, like, you know shit about cars. You just be in the way. Go in the house and study your thesis or whatever, bookworm.
Fine. Didn't want to be out here anyway. Kathy's coming over, so screw studying.
Man, every night with you two. Damn, you guys are like bunnies. Give it a rest.
Well, I don't know if that's gonna happen. She's kind of freaked out about this photo she took of me in the car last night.
Where did you just come from?
What do you mean?
The engine is hot. You must have just driven it.
Yeah, I don't know what to tell you.
Oh, and hey, when Kathy gets here, can you just send her in?
Yeah, man.
Sure.
Hey man, how's it going? Devin? No Devin, no Kathy. What the fuck is going on?
Thank you.
Find a good one?
Yeah. I can only hope all the stories in this book are as good as the ones I just read.
$12.
Seems fair.
I'm not responsible for your nightmares.